In this tutorial, we look into performing regression using Excel. We'll be using our COVID-19 data set. The data has already been cleaned up and only the required columns are available. So this regression can be done using Excel with the help of the Excel feature called Data Analysis Tool Pack. We already saw in the correlation analysis tutorial as to how do we enable the data analysis tool pack. So once that hasn't been enabled, in the data section of this ribbon you see the data analysis tool pack. So once this has been enabled, you can access this feature to perform regression analysis as well as other analysis. So our analysis uses multiple linear regression to model the relationship between new deaths, which would be the dependent variable, and new cases, new tests, new vaccinations, and stringency index as the independent variables. So a linear regression is used to model the relationship between an independent variable and one or many dependent variables. If it is just one independent variable, then it is a simple linear regression. But if it involves many independent variables, then it is a multiple linear regression. Since our analysis involves new cases, new tests, new vaccinations, and stringency index as independent variables, there are four independent variables. This is a multiple linear regression model. So now let's start our regression analysis. But before we do that, you see these three columns. These are new cases per thousand, new tests per thousand, and new vaccinations per thousand. These columns are nothing but the new cases divided by thousand, as you see from the formula. Similarly for the new tests and new vaccinations, each of these values are divided by thousand. This was done so that the interpretation becomes much more easier in the regression output. So to do our regression analysis, let's go to the data section in this ribbon. Let's go to data analysis and let's scroll down to regression. Let's click OK. And the input Y range, the Y is the dependent variable, and in our case new deaths, this was the dependent variable. Let's select the column. Let's go to the X range. In our case, the X range, these are the independent variables, the new cases, new tests, and new vaccinations per thousand, and stringency index. These were our independent variables. Let's select all the values. And our data range consists of labels. So we can get the output in a new worksheet, in a new workbook. Let's do it in a new worksheet. Let's select it. Let's click OK. And there you have the output. So since this is a multiple linear regression, we first need to check the adjusted R-square. If it was a simple linear regression, the R-square would be sufficient. Since it is multiple linear regression, we go to adjusted R square and we see that the value is 0.816, which says that 81% of the variation in Y, which is the 81% of the variation in new deaths, can be explained by these independent variables, the new case, new tests, new vaccinations, and stringency index. So to see if this model is a good model, we'll have to look at the significance value, the F test, which gives the significance value. And if this value is below 0.05, we can say that it is a good model. And so we see that this is way below 0.05, so this is a good model. And as for the coefficients of the dependent variables, we again can see if the dependent variables are significant by looking at the p-values. and if the value is below 0.05, we can include these dependent variables in our multiple linear regression model, and we see that all the values other than stringency index, they are all below 0.05. These three values are below 0.05. Stringency is not significant. Now that we have the regression output, let's see how do we interpret these coefficient values. To make the interpretation easier, let's present a mathematical model of this regression, and that mathematical model would look like this, where y is the dependent variable, new deaths, then you have beta naught coefficient, beta 1, beta 2, beta 3 and beta 4 coefficients. These are these coefficients for the intercept and the dependent variables. So since we already saw that the new cases, new tests and new vaccinations were modified and made per 1000, the new cases per 1000, new tests per 1000, the interpretation will also be made in that sense. So we can say that for new cases, for every 1000 new cases, having all other variables as constant, the number of deaths increases by 7. And for every 1000 new tests, the number of deaths increases by 0.69. But here something interesting can be seen, that for every 1000 new vaccinations, there seems to be a decrease in death, because we see a negative value in the coefficient here. So for every 1000 new vaccinations, the number of deaths seems to be decreasing by minus 0.07. But let's not get carried away here. This is a very small number, and so we cannot be using this to make a conclusive judgment. We cannot say that as the number of vaccination increases, the number of deaths increases. We might have to do further analysis to understand what is really going on. There is also something interesting happening here. If you see the stringency index, it is positive and it is 2.71. That says that as the stringency index increases, the number of deaths increases. This is something really odd, because we would expect that as the measures are made more stringent, as there are more restrictions made, as the policies become more restrictive, the deaths should actually be decreasing. But here we see that the deaths are increasing. As the stringency index increases, the death is also increasing. But at the same time, we cannot make any conclusive judgments here, because we also saw that the p-value is 0.11. It is greater than 0.05, and therefore this is not a significant value. Therefore, we cannot include this in the model. But this is pointing us towards something. It is trying to provide us some insights which we can understand by making further analysis in the data.